الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. The reason why we're talking about celebrating the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's birthday is because we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The reason why we're talking about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday, if we can celebrate it, we're doing it because we love him alayhi salatu wasalam, and it is out of love for him that we are speaking about the ruling pertaining to what celebrating his birthday. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ, say to them Muhammad, if they love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they love Allah, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ, follow me, يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهَ, Allah will love you. So the sign to know that a person loves Allah and is in love with Allah is that individual what? Follows the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my beloved brothers and sisters, is a symbol of Iman. It's an asr min usul al-Iman. It's a fundamental aspect of our religion. And for a person to lie to a people and say that they hate the Prophet, to turn away from the point of discussion, as they call it, as the ulama call it, tahriru mahallun niza', the point of discussion is not whether we love or hate the Prophet, or it's not whether we are against sending salutation on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is not. Rather, we believe sending salutation on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is from the acts that if you come with will get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than our own parents and our children and our own selves as well. That is not the discussion. The discussion is it permissible for a person to celebrate the day in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born? I personally will be speaking about this topic from the angle of تاريخ الاحتفال بالمولد وأول حدوثه. I'm going to be speaking about the history of when did this act start, celebrating the Prophet's birthday. When did it actually occur and when did it actually happen? That's all I'm going to be speaking about. And then when I establish historically the people who started it, I'm then going to speak about their integrity. The ones who innovated it and brought it about, how is their integrity? How is it like? Are they people who are reliable, who are honorable, who are noble, or are they criminals and wrongdoers? And I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, the references that I'm going to use are references agreed by both parties. It's not going to be a biased reference. It's going to be a reference from people who we all should respect and we all should love. Scholars, inshallah ta'ala. If you look at the Prophet's biography and you look at the companions and the students of the companions and the students of the students of the companions, if you go up to 350 years of Hijriyah, Islamic calendar, 350 years after the Prophet ﷺ migrated from Makkah to Medina, you do not find this act being done, the celebration of the Prophet ﷺ. Abu Bakr, the Prophet didn't celebrate it, and Abu Bakr did not celebrate it, and Umar did not celebrate it, and Uthman did not celebrate it, and Ali ibn Abi Talib did not celebrate it. Even the students of these companions did not celebrate it. Nor did the four Imams that we follow today, none of them celebrated. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa did not celebrate it. Al-Imam Imam Malik did not celebrate it. Al-Imam Shafi'i did not celebrate it. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah did not celebrate it. Nor did the students of Imam Abu Hanifa celebrate it. Muhammad ibn Hassan al-Shaybani and Yusuf. None of those two Imams celebrated, who are from the Khawas, from the elite students of Al-Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah. Al-Imam Malik, from his students, Abdullah ibn Wahb and Ma'ar ibn Isa and others, none of them did. Al-Imam Malik, Al-Imam Shafi'i, his student, Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi, Ismail ibn Yahya al-Muzani, and others, no one celebrated it. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, his students, no one celebrated it. So where did this come from? Something our Prophet was not doing, not his companions. I'm saying as far as the four A'immatul Arba'ah, 350 years onwards is when it started. Al-Imam al-Sakhawi, who's from the students of Ibn Hajar. He's the student of Hafidh ibn Hajar. He says, عَمَلُ الْمَوْلِدِ, the celebrating of the Prophet's birthday, لَمْ يُنْقَلْ عَنْ أَحَدٍ مِنَ السَّلَفِ الصَّالِحِ, it has not been transmitted from any pious predecessors. The three generations that the Prophet said to his companions, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي, the best of generation is my generation. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ, and those who come after. ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ, and those who come after. None of them did it. Sakhawi says, فِي الْقُرُونِ الثَّلَاثَةِ الْفَاضِلَةِ وَإِنَّمَا حَدَثَ بَعْدَ, this came after. So who brought it? And who did it come from? The people in which the celebration came from are a people known as Ubaydiyun. They are the first people who came with celebrating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday. There's a car who blocked, its plate number is MK59. It's a white taxi. So it's something that was innovated, introduced by the Ubaydiyun, who called themselves falsely, and by lying, they called themselves Fatimiyun. By saying that they are from the lineage of Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Here is Al-Imam Al-Miqrizi rahimahullah. He has a book called Al-Khutat. The first volume, page 495. Sorry, 490. He says, ذِكْرُ الْأَيَّامِ الَّتِي كَانَ الْخُلَفَاءُ الْفَاطِمِيُّونَ يَتَّخِذُونَهَا أَعْيَادًا وَمَوَاسِمَ تَتَّسْعُ بِهَا أَحْوَالُ الرَّعِيَّةِ وَتَقْثُرُ نِعَمُهُمْ. He talks about the days in which the leaders of the Khulafa al-Fatimiyun. Who are the Khulafa al-Fatimiyun? We'll come to them. But just we want to know that these are the people who made it. We have to historically prove that they're the ones who made it. The Khulafa al-Fatimiyun, they used to have yearly celebration. Through the year, they had celebrations in which they would spend money and financial aid towards it. وَكَانَ لِلْخُلَفَاءِ الْفَاطِمِيِّينَ فِي طُولِ السَّنَةِ أَعْيَادٍ, they had celebrations that they would celebrate. And from those celebrations, he says, is وَمَوْلِدُ النَّبِي, celebrating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday. It's from the things that they used to do. Abu al-Abbas Ahmad ibn Ali al-Qalaqshandi, he says, he has a book called Subh al-A'sha, third volume, page 498. He says, الجلوس الثالث, the third gathering that they would have, جلوسه في مولد النبي, is their sitting, the Fatimiyun, the Ubaydiyun, is their sitting, their gathering, في الثاني عشر من شهر ربيع الأول. They would come together, they would gather, celebrate on the 12th of ربيع الأول. الشيخ محمد المطيعي, he is the Mufti Diyar al-Misri سابقا, he was the Mufti of Egypt. He's not a Wahhabi, he's not from Saudi Arabia. He's a what? He's the Mufti of Egypt. Okay? Al-Sheikh Muhammad al-Muti'i, and he was a Hanafi in Madhab. Al-Sheikh Muhammad al-Muti'i, who was the Mufti Diyar al-Misri, he was the Mufti of Egypt before. He says, مِمَّا أُحْدِثَ وَكَثُرَ السُّؤَالُ عَنْهُ, one of the things that have been introduced and many questions have come regarding it is al-Mawalid, celebrating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday. If we can avoid this, it would be very nice. It would stop in the lecture all the time just because of cars is unnecessary. A Ford Mondeo Black, YK55 YPO. If you've blocked somebody, you know you've blocked somebody, just get up and move your car from the people you're blocked, inshallah ta'ala. Sheikh Muhammad al-Muti'i, who is the Mufti Diyar in Syria, what did he say? Mimma uhditha, one of the things that have been introduced, and many questions have come regarding it, is the celebrating of the Prophet's birthday. فَنَقُولُ our response is, as he's speaking as a Mufti, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَحْدَثَهَا, the first people who introduced celebrating the Prophet's birthday بِالْقَاهِرَةِ in Egypt are الْخُلَفَاءَ الْفَاطِمِيُّونَ, they are the first ones. The Fatimiyun are the first. وَأَوَّلُهُمْ, and from the Fatimiyun, because they were going on for a long time, who specifically? It is الْمُعِزُّ لِدِينِ اللَّهِ, this individual by the name of الْمُعِزُّ لِدِينِ اللَّهِ. He says this in the book أَحْسَنُ الْكَلَامِ فِيمَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِالسُّنَّةِ وَالْبِدْعَةِ مِنَ الْأَحْكَامِ, page 44. الشيخ علي محفوظ رحمه الله, who is also from the what? هو من كبار علماء مصر, he's from the great scholars of Egypt. He's not a Wahhabi. He's not a Wahhabi. He says, إن أول من أحدثها, from the first people who innovated and introduced celebrating the Prophet's birthday بالقاهرة in Egypt are الخلفاء الفاطميون. Is the خلفاء الفاطميون. في القرن الرابع, they started in the 4th century. 4 centuries after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's hijrah. فابتدعوها ستة موالي. They made up four, not one, not two, not three, but four celebrations. And the first of them is Al-Mawlid al-Nabawi, the Prophet's birthday. Wa Mawlid al-Imam Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and celebrating the birth of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Wa Mawlid al-Sayyidati Fatima, and celebrating the birth of who? Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, Fatima al-Zahra. Wa Mawlid al-Hasan wal-Husayn. Wa Mawlid al-Khalifa al-Hadir. And that leader himself, his birthday will be celebrated as well. Ali, Sheikh Ali Mahfouz mentions that in his Kitab al-Ibda' fi Madari al-Ibtida'. Why these particular individuals? Why Ali? Why Fatima? Why Hassan? Why Hussein? What does that snip? What do you get from that? We'll come to what they are. Good. He said, Ali Mahfouz says, وَقَدْ إِسْتَمَرَّ الْعَمَلُ, he carried on saying, this act of celebrating the birthday of the Prophet carried on after the Fatimiyun. إِلَى يَوْمِنَا هَذَا, to this day. He's talking about his time. وتوسع الناس فيها, the people were excessive and exaggerated on it. وابتدعوا بكل ما تهوى أنفسهم, and they added onto it everybody what they thought was good, whatever their desires inclined them to. وتوحيه إليه الشياطين الإنس والجن, and the shaitan, whatever revelation he sent on them, they would do it. Music, rappers, they brought some of them, I saw. ولا نزاع فيها أنها من البدع, and he said there is no debate that this is from the innovation. From the scholars who mentioned it is that Ustaz Sayyid Sadiq in his Kitab Sira' Bayn al-Haqq wal-Batil, Shaykh Muhammad Sa'id ibn Qushayr, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Shaykh, who was the previous Mufti of Saudi Arabia, Ibn Baz, Albani, Ibn Uthaymeen and others, all of those scholars, they stated that the first people who initiated the celebrating of the Prophet ﷺ is who? The Ubaydiyun, who called themselves Fatimiyun, Zuran, وَبُهْتَانًا وَتَضْلِيلًا, to misguide, to lie, to falsely attribute themselves to what? The family of the Prophet ﷺ, and they were not, they were liars. They were not from the Prophet's lineage. But we will prove that inshaAllah ta'ala soon. So the question here is, you've proven to us that the Fatimiyun, Dawlatul Fatimiyun, are the people who started this. Who are they then? What's their integrity like? What kind of people are they? And what did the people of knowledge say about them? If you go to the Kitab Al-Bidayah Wal-Nihayah, written by who? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. When Ibn Kathir is talking about the event of 406 Hijriya, Islamic calendar, 406, the events that happened that year, half of the Ibn Kathir al-Shafi'i, he said, وَكَتَبَ جَمَاعَةٌ مِنَ الْعُلَمَاءِ, a group of scholars, they wrote an essay, they wrote a letter. وَالْقُضَاتِ, the judges of that time, they wrote a letter. وَالْأَشْرَاقِ, the honorable people of the community, they wrote a letter. وَالْعُدُولِ, the reliable people of the community, wrote a letter. وَالصَّالِحِينَ, the pious people of the community, they wrote a letter. وَالْفُقَهَاءِ وَالْمُحَدِّثِينَ, all of those people, they came down and they wrote. جَمِيعًا, all of them. أَنَّ الْفَاطِمِيِّينَ, that the Fatimiyin are مُلُوكَ مِصْرَ, the leaders of Egypt are كفار فساق فجار ملحدون زنادقة معطلون وللإسلام جاحدون ولمذهب المجوسية والثنوية معتقدون قد عطلوا الحدود وأباحوا الفروج وأحلوا الخمر وسفكوا الدماء وسبوا الأنبياء ولعنوا السلف وادعوا الربوبية. These are the ulama of that time. We're talking about the ulama, the qubat, the ashraf, the udul, the salihin, the fuqaha, the muhaddithin. They all testified by saying that the Fatimiyun are kuffar, disbelievers. They are fusaq, transgressors, fujar, wrongdoers, criminals, mulhidun, disbelievers, zanadiqa, heretics, mu'attiluna, dismantled the religion of Allah, walil islami jahiduna, and they are stubborn, hard-headed individuals regarding the book of Allah and the religion, walimadhabi al-majusiyyati wa-thanawiyyati mu'taqidun, and they are believers of the belief of the majusiyya fire worshippers. قَدْ عَطَّلُوا الْحُدُودِ They dismantled the ahkam of Allah. وَأَبَاحُوا الْفُرُوجَ They made zina permissible. They said zina is allowed. وَأَحَلُوا الْخَمْرَ They made the khamr halal. وَسَفَكُوا الدِّمَاءَ They spilled blood in Egypt. وَسَبُّوا الْأَنْبِيَاءَ They insulted the prophets. وَلَعَنُوا السَّلَفَ They insulted the pious predecessors. وَدَّعُوا الرُّبُوبِيَّةَ And they claimed that they were gods. They said we are gods. Now the question is, listen to the great Ash'ari leader, Al-Qadhi Al-Baqilani. What did he say? Ibn Kathir transmits this in his Kitab Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya. He said about the Fatimiyun, هُمْ قَوْمٌ يُظْهِرُونَ الرَّفْضِ They are a people who show that they are Rafida. They admit they are Rafida. They say, we're Rafida. وَيُبْطِلُونَ الْكُفْرِ But what they're hiding in their hearts are disbelief. Al-Mahda, clear-cut kufr. وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ أَعْلَمُ And Allah knows best. This is not a Wahhabi Salafi. The Ash'ari, from the leaders of the Asha'ira, he says, هُمْ قَوْمٌ يُظْهِرُونَ الرَّفْضَ They are a people who show that they are Rafida. And this is the minimum. That's what they agree and they're happy with. But he's saying they're a step further than that. وَيُبْطِلُونَ الْكُفْرَ الْمَحْرَ وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ أَعْلَمُ Hafidh Ibn Kathir goes a step further. He talks about the biography of the man who started it per se. Who is he? Al-Mu'izzu. This individual specifically. All of that which was written was about the Dawlat al-Fatimiyun. Now Ibn Hajar, Ibn Kathir is now going a step further and he's going to talk about the man who started it. Al-Mu'izzu li-Dinillah. Who is he? The Fatimiyun, their Dawla, it started where? It started in Morocco, Maghrib. Okay? It started in Maghrib. Not Morocco, but Maghrib. And Al-Mu'izzu li-Dinillah is the one who moved it from Maghrib, and he entered into Egypt. He brought his Dawlat al-Fatimiyun into Egypt. So the day he came into Egypt, he came to Iskandariya, Alexandria. When he came to the people and he spoke to them. He gave them a khutbah, an eloquent speech. And he said to the people that he's going to give victory to the oppressed and the wronged, those who have been wronged. I'm going to bring you back your rights. And he claimed, وَافْتَخَرَ فِيهَا بِنَسَبٍ He claimed that he's from a particular lineage. That he's from the Prophet's family. He claimed that. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ رَحِّمَ الْأُمَّةَ بِهِ And he said, Allah has made me a mercy for the people. Ibn Kathir says, وَهُوَ مَعَ ذَلِكَ مُتَلَبِّسٌ بِالرَّفْضِ ظَاهِرًا وَبَاطِنًا This man is manifested with him. رَفْض, تَشَيُّعَ الرَّفْض, رَافِضًا Outwardly and inwardly. He says, Then he goes on to say it. He says, to the people that I will bring you back your rights and those who have been wronged, their rights will be received. So what he did was he brought one day, Ibn Kathir says, وَقَدْ أَحْضَرَ إِلَىٰ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ He brought in front of himself one time, A Zahid, Abid, Wari', Nasik, Taqi, Abu Bakr al-Nabulisi. This man is a righteous man. Ibn Kathir referred to him as what? He's a Zahid, an aesthetic person, a person who looks towards the hereafter and turns away from the dunya. A person who's Taqi, righteous and pious. His name is Abu Bakr al-Nabulisi. Al-Mu'izzu li-Dinillah said to him, Balagani anka, it reached me, annaka qulta that you said the following. Law anna ma'i asharatu ashum, that if I had 7 arrows, I would have thrown 9 arrows at the Romans and I would have thrown one of those, the tenth one, the final one, I would throw it at the Dawlatul Fatimiyun. Did you say that? And then he said, Ma qultu hadha, I didn't say that. So what did the Al-Mu'izzin Din Ilahi think? He thought that Abu Bakr al-Nabulisi is retracting his statement, or they lied about him. Then he said, what did you say then? Kayfa qulta, what is it that you said? He said, I said that if I had 10 arrows, 9 of those arrows I would direct at Dawlatul Fatimiyun, and the 10th one I would direct at the Romans. And he said to him, Walima, why would you do that? He said, لِأَنَّكُمْ غَيَّرْتُمْ دِينَ الْأُمَّةِ, you have changed the religion of the people. وَقَتَلْتُمُ الصَّالِحِينَ, and you have killed the righteous individuals. وَأَطْفَأْتُمْ نُورَ الْإِلَهِيَّةِ, and you have extinguished the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَادَّعَيْتُمْ مَا لَيْسَ لَكُمْ, and you have claimed that you own what is not yours. You gave yourselves rights that isn't yours. He said, is that what you believe? Okay. He told him, arrest him, grab him. They grabbed him. The first day he said, take him and parade him in the market, and whip him on the second day with a whip that penetrates through his skin. And then he requested on the third day that his skin gets peeled off from his body fully. And he requested for a Jew man to do this. فَجِيَ بِيَهُودِيٍ, he came with a Jew, because this is not something a Muslim can do. So he brought a Jew man and he requested for the Jew man to do this. The Jew man said he was doing it and he was taking his skin off him like you take the skin of an animal. وَهُوَ يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنِ, he was reading the Qur'an. The Yahudi said, فَأَخَذَتْنِ الرِّقَى, my heart, I became soft seeing the situation of this man. So when I was peeling his skin off and the man is reading the Qur'an, I just didn't want to I didn't want to make him suffer more. So I just took a dagger and I dagged it into his heart so he dies quickly and he doesn't feel the pain. This is what they would do. Now I ask you guys a question. Do we turn away from the Khulafa al-Rashidun and go to the Khulafa al-Fatimiyun, Ubaidiyun? Turn away from Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali and turn towards a people like this? When the Mawlid was done by Al-Mu'izz al-Din Ilah, after him it went. For a period of time in Egypt, people stopped celebrating the birthday of the Prophet. It got reintroduced again by another leader within the Fatimiyun, whose name was Al-Hakim ibn Amrillah. He brought it back again. And he made the people celebrate in Egypt. Who is this man, Al-Hakim ibn Amrillah, who brought him back again? Al-Imam al-Dhahabi in Sir Alam al-Nubala, he says about him, Al-Hakim ibn Amrillah, he says, Al-Hakim ibn Amrillah al-Ubaydi al-Misri al-Rafidi bal al-Ismaili al-Zindiq al-Mudda'i al-Rububiyya. He said, Al-Hakim ibn Amrillah, he's an Ubaydi, he's an Egyptian, he's a Rafidi, he's an Ismaili, he's a Zindiq, he's a heretic. Al-Mudda'i al-Rububiyya, he claimed that he was ilah. He claimed that he was an ilah. He went on to say, وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانِ مَرِيدًا, he was a what? Shaytan. جَبَّارًا عَنِيدًا كَثِيرًا تَلَوِّ, a person who has different cut shades. سَفَّاكًا لِلدِّمَى, he kills excessively. خَبِيثًا نِحْلًا, his religion is filthy. عَظِيمًا الْمَكْرِ جَوَّادًا مُمْدَحًا لَهُ شَأْنٌ عَجِيبٌ وَنَبَأٌ غَرِيبٌ كَانَ فِرْعَوْنَ زَمَانِهِ يَخْتَرِعُ كُلَّ وَقْتٍ أَحْكَامًا يَلْزَمُ الرَّعِيَةَ بِهَا, he was the Fir'aun of his time. He would make up rulings and he would force his followers to go in accordance to it. أَمَرَ بِسَبِّ الصَّحَابَةِ, he commanded that the companions get insulted. وَبِكِتَابَةِ ذَلِكَ عَلَى أَبْوَابِ الْمَسَاجِدِ, and he said that this should be written on the doors of the masajids, the insulting of the companions. وَالشَّوَارِعُ, and it should be written on the roads. وَأَمَرَ عُمَّالَهُ بِالسَّبِّ, all of his workers, he said, you all have to insult the companions. وَبِقَتْلِ الْكِلَابِ, he said the dogs should be all killed. All the dogs should be killed. And he even banned and he made it haram the Qufa' and the Muluqiyya. The Qufa' is a sha'ir that the Egyptians would make water and juice out of it. And the Muluqiyya is a green thing that Egyptians loved. He banned it from them. He also even made haram from them fish that doesn't have skin. It's not allowed. No one's allowed to have it. And some people were selling it after he banned it, and so he killed them. This is all the kalam of Imam Dhahabi said ala min nubala. He says, وَقَبْ حُبِّبَ. In the final stages of Al-Hakim bi Amri Allah, he started to love, and this is something seriously mentioning is a bit sad for me personally, because there's some very graphical statements that he's going to say here, but the tariq has documented, and this is Al-Imam Dhahabi mentioning it. So I'm just a transmitter. If it hurts you or annoys you, or it, then you don't blame me, inshaAllah ta'ala. I'm just transmitting it from the kitab, Sir Alam al-Nubala. There's going to be a point where he's going to say that is very uncomfortable, but I will transmit it because history has documented this. History has documented this. He says, in his final stages, Al-Hakim bi Amri Allah, he started to love to be alone. Because of course, look what he did to everybody. He's killing everyone. So he started to want to be alone. وَبَقِيَ يَرْكَبُ وَحْدَهُ. So he would take a riding beast, he would go to the market with his donkey, and he would take with him a worker. He would take somebody who would work with him. And wallahi brothers, look what he would go through the market, and he would check if people are selling and buying what he said that they could. Pay attention to this. وَبَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ عَبْدٌ ضَخْمٌ. And with him is a black slave. A big, strong black slave. ضَخْمٌ, excessively strong. فَاجِرٌ, criminal, wrongdoer. فَمَنْ وَلِجَ عَلَيْهِ تَهْدِيبٌ. فَمَنْ وَجَبَ عَلَيْهِ تَهْدِيبٌ. Anyone who deserves to be mannered and has gone out of line, أَمَرَ الْعَبْدَ أَنْ يُولِجَ فِيهِ. Will tell the slave to rape him in the market. وَالْمَفْعُولُ يَصِيحُ. And the one who's been raped is screaming. وَأَنْشَأَ دَارًا. Dhahabi's mentioned this. And Imam Dhahabi is mentioning it. وَأَنْشَأَ دَارًا. He made a building. He made a place. And he placed inside it chains. And he made for it seven doors. And he called it Jahannam. Anybody who he was angry with, he would throw them in there. The people who he used to govern, they used to refer to him as Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, Ya Muhyi, Ya Mumit. Now, one really sincerely asks himself, a people who this action that you're doing has been attributed by thiqat, reliable scholars. They said it came from here. It has been introduced by these people. Once you found out, you won't carry an action like that. Knowing that the noble sahabas, the Khulafa al-Rashidun, Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, didn't do it. But the people, when they realized these points, and these points were brought to their attention, and the history documented this, they tried to remove the wasma tu'ar, the blame and the criticism that's been directed at their historical analysis, or the history and where it attributes this action to. So they said, no, the Fatimiyun are not the ones who started it. Hey, who started it? You would think to yourself, they'll say Abu Bakr, Umar, and Uthman, and Ali. But they said, no, it started by Al-Malik al-Mudaffar, the Malik of Irbil. We did you guys a favor by saying that it started at the 4th century. You're saying it started in the 7th century. You're moving further away from the timing of the Prophet. You're saying that Malik al-Mudaffar, the leader of Mudaffar, Malik al-Irbil, and Irbil is a place close to Mosul, right now the Kurdish are the ones that reside there, they live there. The response to this is as follows. Number one, Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, who was at that time, who lived at that current time, he mentions in his kitab, Al-Ba'ithu ala Inkar al-Bid'i wal-Hawadith, he mentions that the Malik al-Mudaffar, the leader of Mudaffar, Malik Mudaffar, of the leader of Irbil, he didn't start that. That he himself, in Irbil, he took it from the worshipper, the Sufi worshipper, Umar ibn Muhammad al-Mulla. He was the one who started it in Irbil. It wasn't even Malik Mudaffar. And if history and Ibn Kathir and others are saying that the 4th century is when it started and the Fatimiyun used to do it, and you say the 7th century is when it started, history could only prove it's what? That it's earlier. We have an early incident where it's happening. So some of the scholars, like Sibt ibn al-Jawzi, and Al-Hafidh Ibn Kathir, they took the opinion that Malik Mudaffar, the king of Irbil, he actually took it from the Fatimiyin. Who said this? Sibt Ibn al-Jawzi in his kitab, Mirqat al-Zaman fi Tawarikh al-A'yan, the 8th volume, page 310. He said he took it from the Fatimiyin. Hafidh Ibn al-Kathir also said that in his kitab al-Bidayah wal-Nihaya, that he took it from the Fatimiyun. Now we say, if you guys say, okay, the Fatimiyun are the one, the Malik Mudaffar, Malik Irbil did it. Isn't that an acknowledge? Isn't that you agreeing that this is an innovation? Isn't this an i'tiraf? You admitting that this is a newly invented matter, regardless of who started it. It's something Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose not to speak about. It is something that Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, no one told us. And wallahi, if there was a path to Jannah, Abu Bakr and Umar would not delay. They would go into it. Now the last point is, this man that they're running to, which is Malik al-Mudaffar, Malik al-Irbil, is he himself a righteous person for them to stick it to him and say he's the one who first did it? Because that's probably why they're running to him, right? The reason why they're probably sticking on him is because maybe he's the one who started it. And maybe because he's a righteous man. So that's why they want to stick it on him. Let's look at what Yaqut al-Hamawi said in his kitab Mu'jam al-Buldan, the first volume, page 167. Because he resided at the time of his as well. He says, وَطِبَاعُ هَذَا الْأَمِيرِ, the nature of this leader, Malik Mudaffar, is مُخْتَلِفَةٌ. He's a person who has split personality. مُتَضَادَّةٌ فَإِنَّهُ كَثِيرَ الظُّلْمِ, he's excessively oppressive. عَسُوفٌ مِنْ رَعِيَةِ رَاغِبُ فِي أَخْذِ الْأَمْوَالِ مِنْ غَيْرِ وَجْهِهَا, he loves to take the people's wealth in an unjust way. وَهُوَ مَعَ ذَلِكَ, but with that said, he's مُتَفَضِّلٌ عَلَى الْفُقَرَاءِ, he's one who gives to the fuqara, and some of the copies they say عَلَى الْقُرَّاءِ, the reciters and the people who read the Quran, he gives to them. كَثِيرُ الصَّدَقَاتِ عَلَى الْغُرَبَاءِ, the money he stole, that he would steal from the people, he would give it to the qurra, and he would give it to what? The poor and the ones in need and the travelers. يُسَيِّرُ الْأَمْوَالَ الْجَمَّةَ الْوَافِرَةِ يَسْتَفِقُ بِهَا الْأَسَارَى مِنْ أَيْدِ الْكُفَارِ, and he would take that money and he would bring back the captives from the disbelievers. So you can see why Yaqut al-Hamawi is trying to say that he has split personality. And then he's saying his example is like, وَفِي ذَلِكَ يَقُولُ الشَّاعِرُ, a poet would say regarding his personality, كَسَاعِيَةٍ لِلْخَيْرِ مِنْ كَسْبِ فَرْجِهَا لَكَ الْوَيْلُ لَا تَزْنِي وَلَا تَتَصَدَّقِي. The Arabs, they have a saying which is, a woman who would receive money from zina, she would go for prostitution, she would get money from it, and then the money she gets, she would pay sadaqah from it. The poet said, لَكَ الْوَيْلُ, destruction be to you. لَا تَزْنِي, don't come with zina, وَلَا تَتَصَدَّقِي, don't do sadaqah. His situation was that he would steal the people's money and then he would pay in what? In sadaqah. Don't steal the people's money and don't pay sadaqah. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to conclude that bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The topic it's longer than that. But this is a historical analysis of what took place celebrating the Prophet's birthday. The next speaker inshallah ta'ala is going to speak about following the Kitab and the Sunnah and the dangers of innovation, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.